Hello student, a very good morning all of you, and you're the most welcome in DSS online English class. Myself Dharmin sir, and I am going to explain the summit within the rest paragraph. Student, I have given you a introduction about the what is the means of summit within. Summit within is a chapter who gives you an inspiration that how a person get their ambition and get their success in your life. And even every person has some peculiar quality, but it's need to recognize them. That means hum sabke paas ek peculiar quality hoti hai jisko zarurat hoti hai pehchanne ki. If you just recognize your capability, the real capability and caliber, then definitely you can do the highest thing what you want to achieve in your life. So student, this is the moral of the chapter, the summit within, and the sense. But here I am going to express some other things or the rest paragraph. So student, let's focus what I am saying here. I have more the personal answer to the question from my childhood. I have been attracted by mountains. That means HPS Ahluwalia says that he has been a great fond of climbing since his childhood. By mountains, I had been miserable, lost, ran away from mountains in the plains. And he also feels a miserable condition way he was out of the mountain climbing. The mountains are nature's at its best. Their beauty and the majesty please. The great challenge. And like many, I believe that the mountains are means of communion with God. That means he always think about the majesty and the charming looks of mountains, and he compares the mountain with the majesty with the God. And he says that the mountains used to attract him deeply for a long time. That means unko kafi lambe samay tak ye cheeze us mountain ki sundarta unko apni or khinchti rahi hai. Once having granted this, the question remains, why Everest? Because it is the highest, the mightiest, and has deflated many previous attempts. It takes the last ounce of one's energy. That means when you decided to climb on the mountain, then definitely a question arises within yourself, that why the mountain? Why the mountain? That because of its height, or because of its exquisite scenes, or because of its a glory history? That's why you want to climb on the mountain. No student, HPS Ahluwalia ask himself that ki akhir mountain par hi chadhna kyun? Uski unchai ke liye hum chadhna chahte hain, ya uski shandar पीक के लिए, स्नो कैप पीक के लिए, या फिर वहाँ से जो सुंदर सी साइड दिखती है उसके लिए? एक क्वेश्चन तो अपने आप अंदर उठता ही है कि हम कोई काम कर रहे हैं तो क्यों कर रहे हैं. जैसे इफ़ यू वांट टू आस्क यू क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाई आर यू स्टडिंग, टू गेट अ गुड जॉब, टू अर्न मनी, आर टू इम्प्रोवाइज योर पर्सनैलिटी, और फिर टू स्टेबल, टू मेक योर नेम इन द सोसाइटी, देन डेफिनेटली a question and the answer will arise in to your own self, that what you want by getting the education. That means aap education kyun le rahe ho? Aapko achhi job chahiye, bahut zyada paise kamane hain, apni personality ko increase karna hai, ya society mein apni ek jagah banani hai. To nishchit hi maybe ki hum sab logon ke motives alag alag ho. Some want to take a study by the great post, some want to make their personality, some want to make a position in the society. This may be different attitude for taking the education, the point of education. So student, Also, SPS Ahluwalia asked himself, and when you try to climb on the mountain, then mountain takes your a last ounce of your energy. That means, जब आप mountain पर चढ़ना चाहते हो ना, तो ये आपके आखरी ounce, ounce that means the smallest unit of your energy. ये आपके शरीर की energy के last unit को भी consume कर लेता है. Means आपके energy को पूरा का पूरा ये consume कर डालता है. It is the brutal struggle with rock and ice, and you have to make a brutal struggle with rock and ice because rock and ice always push you back, but you have to do your best. मतलब ये जो होते हैं हमेशा आपको पीछे की ओर ढकेलते हैं, लेकिन आपको अपना best करना to climb up the mountain. Once taken up, it cannot be given up a halfway even when one's life is at stake. The passage back is as difficult the passage onward, and then when the summit is climbed, there is an acceleration, a joy of having done something, the sense of a battle fight and on. There is a feeling of a victory, of a happiness. That means when you want or when you start the climbing of a mountain, then you have to fight with the mountain, then you have to fight with the rocks, you have to fight with the ice, and when you climb up, then you feel a sign of a victory inside you. That means जब आप चढ़ते हैं तो आपको बहुत सारी चीज़ों से लड़ना पड़ता है, और साथ ही साथ आपको उन चीज़ों से जब जीत जाते हैं तो आपको एक बहुत बड़ा विक्ट्री महसूस होता है. Glimpsing a peak in the distance, I get transported to another world and experience a change within myself. And when you reached on the top of a mountain, and from there you see below, then you see that the vast glory of the earth, and that you feel that you have owned your object. You know, object. That means आपने अपना एक object को जीत लिया है. Which can only And I experience a change within myself, which can only be called mystical. And you experience a change within yourself, and this change fills you a mysterious sense, mysterious feeling. Means, जब आप चढ़ जाते हो, तो ये अनुभव आपको एक mysterious feeling देता है. By its beauty, a fullness might rugness and the difficulties encountered on the way, the peak draws me to it as Everest did. It is a challenge that is difficult to resist. That means when you try to climb on that on the peak, then you have to face the rock, you have to struggle with the stones, you have to struggle with the suffocation, and when you want to own your object, then you have to experience a challenge, and that challenge could not be resisted. Means jab aap chadhna chahte ho to aapko bahut sari pareshaniyon ka samna karna padta hai, aur us samay aapko ek challenge feel hota hai, और इस चैलेंज को कभी रेसिस्ट नहीं कर सकते आप. सो स्टूडेंट, आई थिंक यू गॉट द कंप्लीट सेंस व्हाट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग हियर, एंड दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज इफ यू वांट टू मेक योर कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर, देन यू हैव टू लिसन इट वेरी केयरफुली. लुकिंग बैक, आई फाइंड दैट आई हैव नॉट येट फुली एक्सप्लेन्ड व्हाई आई क्लाइम्ड एवरेस्ट. It is like answering a question, why you breathe, why do you help your neighbors, why do you want to good acts. There is no final answer the possible. And when Ahluwalia says that, looking back, find that I have yet fully explained why I have climbed Everest. That means when Ahluwalia climbed on the mountain, and he want to explain that he thinks that something is missing while I am explaining. That means I couldn't explain completely my feelings, that why I climbed on the Everest. It's like answering a question, why you breathe. It is just like a question, that why you breathe. That means Ahluwalia ye kehna chahte hain ki aap jab mountain pe chadhte ho to us samay aap se fir question pucha jata to aap shayad apne anubhav ko purn roop se answer nahi kar pate, aur ye bilkul ek aise question ki tarah ki aap saans hi kyun lete ho. That means ye, this is a deep meaning student you have. That means why you breathe. That means agar aapko breathe lena bahut zaruri hai to utna hi zaruri apne life mein jo aapne ambition bana rakha hai us ambition ko pura karna zaruri hai. That means the great inspirational word. Student, take inspiration by this word, that if you want, if you make a purpose in your life, then you have to achieve. You try to achieve until your last breath. अपने आखिरी सांस तक आपको अपने गोल को पाने के लिए हमेशा कोशिश करते रहना चाहिए. Neighbors, why do you help your neighbors? And then ask, why do you help your neighbors? That means this is our neighbors, and this has a very close kinship. That's why I help him. So when you decide to get anything, then definitely the inner inspiration push you that you should try to get, try to fill your ambition. Why do you want to good acts? And there is no final answer possible. And why you want to do good acts? And I think, according to Ahluwalia, that I think there will be no clear answer that why you want to get to success in your life. This answer cannot be possible to explain. So student, the next paragraph, and then there is the fact that Everest is not just a physical climb. The man who has been to mountain top becomes conscious and especially manner to his own smallness in the large universe. And that means the final experience, that when a person got reached on the top of a mountain, then he feels that he was a tiny person and he was tiny in this large or vast world. He feels that he is a very tiny because of this height. The world look like a very tiny thing. Small is the large universe. The physical conquest of a mountain is only one part of a achievement. And the physical conquest, the main thing is that if you want to reach on the top of a mountain, that the main thing is that you have a physical strength as well as the mental strength. It is not necessary that you have only physical strength. It is also necessary that you have a mental strength also, because without mental strength you cannot be achieve your ambition, what you have defined in your life. There is no more to it than that. It is followed by the sense of fulfillment. There is the satisfaction of a deep urge to rise above the one's surrounding. It is the eternal love that adventure its man experience. It is not a merely physical, it is a emotional and it is a spiritual. That further Ahluwalia says that it is not a only mental and physical strength, it is a matter of a spiritual also, because if you set up a goal in your life, then you should be spiritual toward them. Student, आपने अगर अपने लाइफ में कोई गोल सेट किया है ना, तो आपको उस गोल के प्रति सिर्फ फिजिकल और मेंटल स्ट्रेंथ नहीं, बल्कि उसमें स्पिरिचुअल, यू शुड मेक द स्पिरिचुअल गोल ऑफ दैट डिफाइंड गोल. मींस आपने जो डिफाइंड गोल किया है उसके लिए स्पिरिचुअल एक लगन होनी चाहिए उसको पाने के लिए, देन डेफिनेटली यू विल गेट. कंसिडर अ टिपिकल क्लाइंब toward the summit on its large height. You are sharing a rope with another climber, and when you start your climbing, and then the followers who has also hanging with the rope, then towards the summit on the last height, you are sharing a rope with another climber you form in. He cuts the steps in the hard ice, then the belays, and you inch your way up. The climb is grim. You strain every nerve as you take every step. That means when you share the rope with other climbers, then the other climbers make a grip, make a hole or make a wound in the ice, and that is helpful to climb. So student, जैसे आप अगर climb किसी climb पे चढ़ते हो, तो उस समय जैसे एक climber जब चढ़ता है तो वो क्या करता है, वो ice में थोड़ी सी hole बनाता है जिससे कि वो अपने पैरों को उस पे रख के आसानी से चढ़ सके. एंड दिस इज अ वेरी हेल्पफुल इन क्लाइंबिंग, ये क्लाइंबिंग में बहुत हेल्पफुल होता है. यू स्ट्रेन एवरी नर्व, यू टेक एवरी स्टेप, एंड व्हेन यू टेक अ स्टेप यू फील अ सडन जर्क इन योर नर्व. दैट मीन्स आपके नसों में एक झटका सा महसूस होता है जब आप एक स्टेप आगे बढ़ते हो क्लाइंबिंग में. फेमस क्लाइंबर have left record for the help given by the others. They have also recorded how they needed just that help, else they might have given up. Breathing is a difficult. That means on the top of a mountain, the breathing becomes very difficult, and when you want to take a breath, then you will have to feel a suffocation. That is the major thing. And HPS Ahluwalia want to express these things, what he felt while he was climbing on the mountain. They have also my recorded yours, my breathing is the difficult. You curse yourself for having let yourself in for this. You wonder why you are ever overtook the ascent. There are moments when you feel like going back. It would be sheer relief to go down instead up, up. That means when you are climbing up of the mountain, then you feel a sheer jerk in your nerve. But while you are going downward, it takes some relief that it feels that you are going to take your ambition, you are going to fulfill your victory. That means जब आप ऊपर चढ़ रहे होते हैं तो ये आपको उतना ही suffocation देता है, लेकिन जब आप नीचे उतर रहे होते हैं ना, तो आपको ये थोड़ी सी राहत देता है और ऐसे लगता है कि जैसे अब हम अपनी victory को प्राप्त करके धीरे धीरे नीचे उतर रहे हैं. See a relief down instead of up. But almost at once you snap out of that mood. There is something in you that doesn't let you give up the struggle, and when you just snap in your mind, that means when you think that what are you doing, and any weakness in your memories, then definitely you feel that you are going to give up. That means you should never leave your struggle, leave your firm determination while you are doing such difficult task. That means जब आप इस तरह के कठिन काम कर रहे होते हो ना, तो आपको अपना जो mental strength है उसको एक पल के लिए भी छोड़ना नहीं होता है. That means you have to give your full attention from beginning to the end, then you will get your ambition. So student, I think what I am explaining, have you got the complete sense? That if you have any doubt, then you can ask me. So student, thank you, and the rest paragraph will explain the next.